As one of Time Magazine's 100 most influential people of the century, Bruce Lee revolutionized martial arts and became a cultural icon.
Bruce Lee was a person who was charismatic and he was powerful. You put the two together, that's gold.
Born in San Francisco on November 27, 1940, Bruce Lee was raised in Hong Kong and began acting as a young child. At 13, Lee studied Wing Chun Kung Fu under Grandmaster Yip Man, and by 18, he returned to the States.
Bruce Lee was a born fighter. He had talent, which is man-made, and he put it all together, and he believed the individual is more important than any style or system.
During the 60s, Lee developed his own style of martial arts. Known for his well-honed physique and impressive strength, Lee showcased a two-finger push-up and had a one-inch punch that could knock a man down to his seat.
Bruce Lee was a very impressive martial arts fighter because of his explosive speed and strength and power. And he developed that because he studied the skeletal system, the muscle system. He went above and beyond training.
For sure, he's the grandfather of mixed martial arts. I have that book, The Tao of Yit Kune Do, and I was just amazed what he put in there. And I mean, we see judo throws, we see setups with punching combinations. We have neck cranks, leg locks. I mean, everything in mixed martial arts is there.
Lee landed the role of Kato on the TV series The Green Hornet and gained notable students such as James Garner, James Coburn, and Steve McQueen.
If it hadn't been for Bruce Lee doing martial art films, I don't think we would see action stars like Jean-Claude Van Damme, Chuck Norris, myself, doing martial art movies, because we were just martial artists. We didn't have aspirations to do film. We would probably just be teaching.
In 1971, Lee returned to Hong Kong and broke Chinese box office records with Fists of Fury and The Chinese Connection. In 1972, Lee co-founded his own production company and directed Return of the Dragon, which introduced the world to Chuck Norris.
Bruce Lee's definitely a hero to me because he was the first Asian person that opened the door for all other Asian actors, stunt coordinators, fight coordinators to be able to work in Hollywood.
In 1973, Lee began filming Game of Death, but left to star in Enter the Dragon, the first Chinese martial arts film to be produced by a major Hollywood studio. 6 days before the film's release, Bruce Lee died on July 20, 1973, from cerebral edema caused by a reaction to prescription medication.
As a martial artist, I consider Bruce Lee to be one of the best. He had something also on screen that nobody else has, and even to this day, as an actor or a martial artist, nobody can copy his movements. Bruce Lee was one in a million.